Do you want to have a good joke? Hang on a second, don't go away now. Don't go away. You want to buy a duck? It's a moustache. I got it in a Christmas cracker. It's just like my Aunt Lucy's. Well, except of course hers is real. Oh, I had a lovely Christmas. Oh, it was terrific. We had all the trimmings, the turkey and everything, and too much to... Here I am, chatting away to you. You don't even know who I am. Well, I'm Ethel. This is my kitchen. This is my kettle. Well, we can see that. Ethel's kettle. Gonna have a nice cup of tea. Have to do with the water that's in there. Tap dance. Terrible joke. It's a terrible... I should warn you, really, that I'm known for telling terrible jokes. I've been telling terrible jokes ever since I was small. Well, I'm still small, but, you know, even smaller. My father picked me up and he said, "Ah, oh, what a treasure." And my mother said, "Yes, let's bury her." Corny joke. Corny flakes. Have a bit of breakfast. I'm always starving in the morning. Now, let's see. Bit of cereal, she said weekly. Weekly cereal. Now, I've got the cereal and I need...
Morning,
Dawn. Paper, thanks very much. And a bit of milk. Bit of cow juice in the morning. There we are.
Not the milk.
Oh, sorry, Dawn. Sorry, Dawn. There you are. Okay.
Thank you.
Now, let's have a look and see what we've got in the paper today. Have a look at the stars. I love the stars. See, my birthday's May the 3rd. I'm a Taurian. That's Taurus. Now, let's have a look here and see. Ah, Taurus. You'll meet a tall, dark, handsome stranger. What a lot of bull. Aries. We'll have a look at Aries. Percy's Aries. Oh, I haven't met Percy yet, have you? Well, he's Aries. Hot Aries. Oh, there's an article here about New Year's resolutions. Well, I've made a New Year's resolution, and my New Year's resolution is to always finish off everything that I start to... Do you know what I found under the stairs? Dawn's diary. Not Mrs. Dale's diary, Dawn's diary. Now, you really... You shouldn't look in people's diaries, but we'll have a quick... See, May the... No, that looks boring. May the 21st was a Tuesday. I fear I am becoming schizophrenic. Ooh. May the 22nd. Someone has been writing in my diary. Never, ever look in other people's... It's very rude. Never look in other people's diaries, but you can look in other people's papers. Oh, have you seen this? On the front page. Oh, this is lovely. You'll love this. This is the first bride of the year. Hang on a second, I'll show you. Have a look. Can you see that? She's the very first bride of this year. Isn't that lovely?
My heart's delight. And away
morning,
you
morning, Percy.
Morning, Ethel.
You say good morning this morning.
Good morning this morning.
Oh, it's very good. Good morning this morning. What have you got there, then?
Pardon?
What have you got there?
It's a ladder.
Oh. Anybody rung for me? Ladder. Rung. What are you putting up?
It's a letter.
Oh, post's early this morning. Well, doesn't seem to be anything that interesting in the paper this morning. I'm going to have a bit of breakfast. Actually, having breakfast is something of a treat for me, because, you see, I've been on this series of diets. No. But anyway, they didn't work very well. First, I was on this seafood diet. You know, I'd seafood and I'd eat it. And that didn't work very well. So then I went on to this whole food diet and I'd eat any kind of whole food, you know, like a whole cabbage or a whole pig or a whole cow or anything absolutely, you know, whole. Because, you see, I've got a very big mouth. I've got a huge mouth. And I can get my whole fist in my mouth. You watch this.
Life divine.
Can I have some breakfast, Percy?
Love some.
Cup of tea?
Love some.
Tea up, everybody! Come on, tea up. Kettle's boiled.
Come on.
Who's having tea?
Me, please.
Oh, orange, please.
Orange, please.
Fussy.
Orange. Can you... Don't get the mugs. Get a bit of orange. Right, come on, what do you get for Christmas?
Orange in here.
A bike. Alarm clock radio.
An alarm clock radio. What did you get?
I've got a bike as well.
A bike as well?
Where's Dawn?
Where's Dawn?
Oh. I don't know.
Take those out.
There we are.
That's a cup of tea for you. There we are, darling. A bit of orange. Oh.
Don't know, doing all this drinks makes me want to go and powder my nose. Why don't you go and sit down over there and I'll find Dawn for you?
All right.
Oh, shall I go to the loo as well? Be quite a queue. Queue for the loo. In lieu of the queue. Queue in the loo. Harry! Harold, I
want
to go to the loo.
What is it?
Harold, have you got a book in there?
No, it's a dictionary. What is it?
Well, come down and have your breakfast then, please.
Wait a minute.
What?
Schizophrenia.
I'm sorry. What? Say hello first.
Oh, hello. Yes. Look, it's my New Year's resolution to learn a new word every week, right?
Well, you might try please once in a while.
No, listen. Schizophrenia.
Yes.
Inability to distinguish reality from unreality.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, right, there's a bloke. Mm. And he's got two voices in his head. Yes. One saying, I love you, I love you, I love you. And the other one saying, I hate you, I hate you.
Harold, for goodness sake, what'd you do that for?
Sorry, yeah. Well, that's the bad voice inside of me, the word of the week, schizophrenia.
Schizophrenia? Who said that?
Well, you did, Ethel.
Oh, well, I've always been in two minds about schizophrenia. Come on, come downstairs and say good morning properly.
Morning properly.
Percival, I've had a bit of an accident upstairs.
Oh, I'm sorry, Ethel.
No, not me, the knob. It's been a long I thought we would have a little bit of a cartoon this morning. I thought we'd have a nice cartoon. Harold!
Is that the off?
What are you doing up there?
Oh, well, eat me cornflakes.
Yes, and?
Well, I'm playing a game.
Oh, on your own?
Well, it's a game I invented, you see. I got this word, you see. And the letters that make this word are jumbled up and hidden all over the house.
Oh. Are they difficult to find?
Very difficult to
I've
find.
Because I've seen
them.
One, there's one down.
Don't tell them, Ethel. Oh, it's a secret.
Sorry.
Thing is, we got this word, you see. Get all these letters, right? And if you find all these letters, there's 10 of them, right? Why don't you let us know what the word is, all right? Okay.
Oh, that sounds like a good
schizophrenia.
Game.
Schizophrenia!
Not schizophrenia. Smaller word than schizophrenia.
Is it? Oh, well,
much
good game.
Smaller. Good game.
Good game.
Very good game.
Now, what was
that for breakfast? Now for my exercises. Where are the others? Oh, wait, come on, kids. We'll see how fit you look. Bring your tail up. Right, let's have a look at your muscles. Come on, tense your muscles. Ooh. Ooh, puny, like Percy. Oh, lovely. Right, spread yourselves out.
I'm good going, yes, is it?
Reckon you're good? I bet you can't do this.
Oh, Dawn!
Oh, Dawn!
It's all right, don't worry. I've got
schizophrenic legs.
Gotta keep it if you're gonna be a good disco dancer. All right, we'll do something easier. Right, this is easy. Stretch your arms to the ceiling. Right, like that. Higher, that's it. Like this. Then we're gonna go down and we're gonna try and touch our toes. Or the floor if you can. Keep going. Doesn't matter if you can't do it, the main thing is to have a go. Go on! You boys are rubbish, come on.
That's easy.
I think you're right.
And you, come on. All right.
Girls. Bend further.
Right, up again. Up again, right. You lot want to join in?
All right.
Oh, no, I've got a bone in my leg. Big bone in my leg.
Try it.
Right, okay. This time we're going to go down and we're going to try and put our head on our knees and put your hands on your ankles and down. All right, go. All right, head on your knees.
Very difficult.
Try not to bend your legs if you can. It's good for the backs of your legs, this. Go on. And you lot. Oh, look at you. What's that? Go on. Okay? Right. We're going to do another one this time. Up. Percy, you want to have a go?
All right. Yeah,
right. This one's much longer. It's in eight parts, all right? So we'll go through it slowly to start with. All right? Number one is like this.
Excuse me.
Number two, hands on your knees. Good for your legs. Number three, you go down like this. Touch the floor. Number four, throw your legs out the back, right? Number five, bring your knees in. Number six, arch your back, screw your face up. Like that. Number seven, right leg. Number eight, left leg. And up again. Start again. Percy?
All right.
Is it? What do you mean, silly? And. Two.
Oh, my legs. I'll show it on the blind. Shall I put it on the blind? Right, come on, cartoon time, everybody. Come on, yes, we're going to have a nice cartoon. This one is called Cape Horn, Fog Horn, Leg Horn, Arm Horn, Cape Horn, Fog Horn. Tell me like that. I don't know. Fog Horn, Leg Horn, Arm Horn. Could be. Oh, it was terrific. It was I say, boy. I say, boy. Oh, it's telephone. I'll get it. I'll just move the ladder. Hello, Southampton 826011. That is the most appalling suggestion I have ever heard. I'll be round in a minute. No, madam, I wasn't being facetious at all. I'm sorry. No, I'm afraid you have got the wrong number, but do pop round and see. Hello? How was the wrong number? She's hung up. Hello, Southampton 826. Hello? Southampton 826011? No, I'm afraid you've got the wrong number, but just a moment, I'll connect you. It's for you. Let them sort it out. I don't know. What are you doing, Harold?
I'm making tea, Ethel.
Well, I've heard of being thirsty, but isn't that a bit ridiculous?
It's for the band.
What band, Harold?
The Q-tips. They stayed last night, Ethel.
Where did they stay, Harold?
In the lounge.
Harold, come. What band? Well, you better come another
minute. Here, tea up, boys.
Oh.
Got tea.
This, Ethel.
Morning. Got tea.
This is the Q-tips.
Q-tips. How
now,
do you?
Now, that's Sir Paul. He's the lead singer.
How do you do? Oh, sorry.
What's your Paul?
Thank you.
Now, and that's Tony. He's on the trumpet. Yeah, Tony. Oh, sorry, mate.
The
there's your tea.
For goodness' sake.
There you are.
Yes. That's all right,
this is Ian. He's on keyboards.
Would you rather be on the floor than on the keyboards? I don't know.
And this is Barry. He's on drums.
Oh, did you have your whole kit in your bag?
And down there, that's Garth on guitar.
Garth on guitar.
Cup of tea.
Sorry,
yeah, cup of tea.
Good morning.
Hello.
Cup of tea.
Bring along with me.
Oh, come on, Ethel, you need. There's your tea, Garth.
How do you do?
Right, this is Fixit. He's on baritone sax.
No sax in my living room, please.
And this is Mick. He's on guitar.
Cheers, Eric.
And this is Nick.
If I could just get over here.
Ethel, this is Nick. He's on center guitar.
Oh,
center guitar.
Good job.
Catch
that.
Oh. He's on, what's he on? Oh, it's a tenor sax.
What are they doing here?
Well, they're going to play music, Ethel.
Well, beats playing hockey in the living room, really, doesn't it?
Show how it's done, boys. Come on.
Three.
What did you think?
I loved it. We'll have a bit later on. I think you should spruce yourselves up, get up, you know, buff yourselves up, and have your cup of tea, and I'll see you in a bit, okay? Toodaloo. We're just going. Toodaloo.
See you later. Listen, lads, listen.
Very nice voice.
Oh,
will you get the door?
Oh.
Thanks.
Where
was I going?
I don't know. Busy.
Oh, someone in the kitchen. Where I was going. Now, let's see. We just put this over here, out of the way. Oh, I should tell it, Harry is lovely. Every week he brings some nice band to see us, you see, and they come and they play a bit of music. Now I learn all about the modern music, you see. And they're called, this one's called Q-tips. Well, it's Q-tips. I think they're called Q-tips.
It's post-bag time.
It's what?
Post-bag time.
Post-bag time! Play! Okay! Post-bag
time! Music.
It's a sting.
Oh, nice.
Music sting.
Nice sting, yeah.
Shall I move this out of the way so we can get plenty of room for the post bag?
Let's see what we got. Delve deep, delve deep. Oh, look.
Oh, let's have a look. We'll have a look at that later.
Right.
Letters. I like the letters first.
Yeah.
Here's what. Oh! Which one shall I open for? Oh, this one looks important.
Oh.
This one looks important.
Who's it from?
I love letters. Don't you love letters?
Who is it from? Surprise.
Oh.
3 Flood Street. A bit wet.
It's from Margaret Thatcher.
Margaret?
From Margaret Thatcher. Prime Minister. My dearest Ethel. I'm the Prime Minister.
The Prime Minister.
Quite something, isn't it? I'll come straight to the point, so pay close attention. Or should I do it as my...
Do it.
I understand that you need some furniture for number 73.
That's here.
Well, here at number 10, I've got a cabinet I hardly ever use, and so I would be pleased for you to take it. My fond regards to you and the others. Happy New Year, Margaret. Oh, I treasure that. Three Flood Street. That's terrific.
So nice, isn't it?
Lovely, lovely sort of.
What's next?
From the gas board.
Could be a bill.
My boy Bill is a... Sorry.
Dear Miss Davies, thank you for your letter of the 12th concerning a gas supply to your house. Mm. We understand that there is already an adequate supply of natural gas on your premises and that laughing gas may also be found leaking out on occasions. That's what it says. As to your request for permission to erect a North Sea oil platform in your backyard, I have passed your letter on to the Department of Energy, who will no doubt take 3 years to process your request and then forget all about it. No, sorry, that just slipped out. I should have said, Happy New Year and keep laughing, love from Ernie the Gas Man. Oh, that was lovely.
Oh,
I love that.
Thanks, Ernie. Now, thanks a lot. Oh, looks like postcard report, doesn't it?
From postcard report? Love from Smithy. Smithy! Oh, we'll have a look at that later.
Absolutely.
On, shall we? That's now one.
Dear Ethel.
My name is Damien. And I come to your house a long time ago, and you said I should write to you if I saw anything funny. Well, I have. My sister. Oh, no! Well, I have. My sister is called Charlotte, and she sat on her bacon and eggs by mistake. It was very funny, but my mum didn't think so. Love, Damien, age 7. I'd like to see that.
That was a 7, aye.
Dawn, what are you doing?
Yeah, what are you doing?
Well, that's the posters, Ethel. We don't mind,
well,
do you?
Mind Percy's nice cupboards. I don't want to mess now.
Careful.
All the things that's happening down this way. Annual hospital pantomime, Hansel and Gretel.
Oh.
To be held in the nurse's recreation room. Bit of a squash, don't you think?
Absolutely.
Bit of a squash. And that's, where's that? Oh, that's in Portsmouth.
Portsmouth.
And this one, look, Aladdin. Fun for everyone at the Dome, Brighton. Music, fun, the real family pantomime.
Oh, yes.
Oh, lovely.
Good one, Dawn.
Lovely. That's the one where the genie comes out, isn't it?
Oh, genie.
Out of the lamp.
I dream of genie.
It's Toad of Toad Hall.
Oh. Like to see that, Dawn.
Molan Theatre, and that's in Swanage.
Mm-hmm.
Lovely. And there's this one, Noah's Ark Ball. Noah's Ark Ball at, where's that?
Sarah's Green
Community Centre on January the 16th. Ooh, lots of animals.
Exciting.
Fun. Yeah.
Ooh, seven all.
It's nice to know what's going on, isn't it?
Yeah, seven all.
If you've got anything happening and you'd like me to know about it, why don't you do a poster, put your name on the address on the back so we know who sent it, send it in, and I'll stick it out with all the
things. Yeah, but can we have nice posters, please? I don't want any rubbish. I want things, nice class of posters that goes well on my cupboard, you know, nice colours.
Hold on, Ethel. Don. How will they know where to send it to?
Oh, that's a good point, yes.
I've made a poster.
Oh, clever girl.
All right, I'll put it up there. Yes. That's where you send your posters to. Number 73, P.O. Box 73.
Yes.
Southampton, S09, S01E01. That's where you send them to.
Good one.
I'll put a stamp on that. Oh, Telly, everybody!
Ethel, a letter from Sydney.
When we come back, we'll
bought
these
for
carrots.
Yeah. When the game's on,
yeah. Just the two,
right? Speechless. I've got courage. Stand by, it's ready to go. Yeah. As soon as I keep, when I get near the time, just keep chatting and chatting and chatting, and then I'll wave you away.
Okay, okay.
So that you're actually chatting when we come to you. 9, 8, 7, 6. Small talk, man.
I have terrible trouble with this screw, Ethel.
No, that's
right.
I've got the screw in now.
Listen, I've got one more letter here which I haven't read. Shall I have a look? Shall I have a look? See who it's from?
Yeah.
It's from Sydney Harbour. Oh, he's a nice chap. He's very nice. We met him in a telephone booth. Actually, he's got a lovely sister. What's she called? What's her name? Pearl. Pearl Harbour. Ever such a nice girl. Now let's have a look. Dear Ethel, Happy New Year.
Thank you, Sydney.
Is that nice? That's lovely. Thanks so much for asking me down to number 73 to play some games. Unfortunately, Saturday is my busy day. Oh, I know what you mean. Saturday, always busy. As I have to clean the village traffic lights. Ooh. And also, the kids all come round to my house to play games. But if you'd like to drop in on me and the kids, you'd be more than welcome. In fact, if you tune in on 27.73 megawhoopers, you might find me. Very best wishes. Keep on grinning. Sydney Harbour. Can we do that?
Yes. I've invented this machine here, you see.
Oh, he's very
it's
clever,
a two-way video steam radio.
Schizophrenic, two-way.
Schizophrenic. And it allows us to see what's going on outside, you see. Give it a press here, press here. Just turn here.
Look, what's it's working.
There we are. Look, pull by.
Yeah, that's not what we want. We want Sydney.
No, it's... Near it.
It's coming. Hello, Sydney. No, hello, darling. Are you there, Sydney?
Oh, there he is. Sydney.
Hello, Sydney.
Hello. Hello, Ethel.
Hello.
Sydney Harbour here. Just doing a spot of window cleaning. Hang on a second. Oh, I won. Hey, there's another version, though. It's called Archie. Shall I show you? Well, Sydney fired. I'll get the kids to show us. Hey, kids! You see, it's like noughts and crosses, but you play with people in spaces. It's a bit... Oh, hang on a sec. You see, you can go here. Or you can go here. Or you can go here. Or even here. In the centre again. Or up at the top. So, all we need are two captains. Two captains, two teams. You go first.
Red centre. Yellow top left,
that's over there.
Red top right.
Top right. So there we are, Ethel. You getting the hang of it?
Yellow.
Dead simple, isn't it?
Bottom.
But there's a bit of a Sydney shuffle at the end. Yellow there.
Red centre left. Yellow. Centre right.
Yellow centre right. Centre right over there. That's it.
Red.
That's it.
Bottom centre. Yellow top centre.
Yellow top right at the back. Now, Ethel, we've got a bit of a stalemate. Well, unlike noughts and crosses where you just throw it away, we can now Sydney shuffle them all around. Very simple. Off we go then.
Red four. Bottom right.
So she moves across to there. Your go, Goldilocks.
Yellow two, bottom centre.
Oh!
Red three to bottom left.
Wallop! There's the line. And that's Archie for you. Dead simple, Ethel. All right? So remember, that's one for the bathroom at number 73, isn't it? And don't forget, keep on grinning, Ethel. Right, kids, come on back here. Let's have another game. Right, you go first.
What's it called, this game?
Archie, I think.
Oh, bless you.
Oh, thank you.
Looks a bit difficult.
Yeah, very difficult. Very difficult.
Oh, well, let's see if we have a go. We'd have a try. Now, what can we play with? We could use
salt and pepper.
Good idea.
Brilliant, Bobby. Go and get salt and pepper.
Very bright.
I've got some more salt and peppers here. There's some in there. And play it on here. I'll make a diagram. Come round. Let's have it. Who's going to be on my team?
Hey, Bobby!
What's your name?
Bobby Neffle.
Neffle, come with me, Lisa, all right?
Now, I'm going to make a mess of my surfaces.
Oh. Comes off, this. Wipes off, though.
Does it? Oh, that's all right.
Wipes
then.
Off.
And like that. Like that. Where else have I got to have lines? Oh! Oh! I'm sorry, Bobby. Oh, I've made a mess of Bobby now. Right.
There we are.
How's that?
Who now, goes first,
you've got to get... Now, I'll see if I've got this right.
Oh, right.
You've got to get in a straight line.
Straight line.
Is that right? Like
yeah.
that?
Yeah.
Or like that?
Vertical,
or
diagonal,
like that?
Or horizontal.
Have I got that?
That's right.
Okay. I'll put that away. Let's have a go, then.
Who's first?
We're first.
Oh, cool. Right. You go first. Your turn.
What do you think, Bobby?
Time for a move. Lisa? Salt, salt, pepper. Pepper, pepper, salt.
Right, that one. We're not doing very well, are we?
Salt, salt.
Haven't got a winner yet.
Salt, pepper. No, haven't got a winner yet.
No.
Keep going, keep going. Achy.
Oh, Ethel.
Yes, Dool?
Who's in the loo?
How do I know? I'm playing a game here.
I'm dying to
go. Well, go and bang on the door. Go on, out you go. Come on.
I can't do anything. Salt, man.
Right.
Let's try again.
Come on, then. We're going to win. I'm sure we're going to win.
Whose turn is it?
Ours.
Yours.
Right. Oh, is it?
Oh. Yeah. Oh,
cheat.
Right, Lisa. On you go, Lisa.
Oh, who are you?
Oh, I'm John.
What are you doing?
I'm just finishing off this poster.
Oh, who's it for?
It's for Ethel. She's asked me to do it.
Oh, let's have a look. That's really nice, isn't it? Have a look. It's really good, isn't it? So what gave you this idea?
Well, Ethel said that she wanted a poster.
Yeah.
And she said it must have the front door on there.
Yeah.
Number 73. That's the front door. Mm-hmm. And also, there wants to be somewhere to put a child's name on it.
Oh, right. So, is that here?
That's, yes, what I'm going to do is put the name in there.
See?
And apparently what she's going to do is that when children have sent in ideas to her,
mm-hmm.
we're going to put the name of the child on there and send them each a personalised poster.
That's great. That's lovely. So, they all get one with their name here?
That's right, yes.
That's really nice.
Do you want to see some of the roughs I did?
Yes.
Before I got to that one. Well, that's the first idea, which was perhaps to have the child's
so
name.
Have a look. There. Here.
Have the child's name in there.
Yeah, a bit formal.
A bit formal, right. So the other idea.
Yeah.
Slowly getting better.
Yeah.
Was perhaps a newspaper through the door.
Yeah.
Or I suppose it should be a comic or something like that. And then we put the name of the child.
Here.
Up there.
That's
see?
Upside down, though.
Upside down, not very good.
No.
So, the third idea was that one.
Yeah.
And have a cartoon hand poking through the...
Oh, that's lovely. Box. And with the eyes as well.
Yeah, so I thought put some eyes in there.
Yeah, that's much more fun, isn't it, than the others. See?
So, I'm now just trying to finish it off.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd get a bit of peace and quiet in here.
All right.
And,
yeah. What colours are you going to do?
Well, I think this will probably be dark blue, something like that, and then I'm going to have another colour.
The door's
colour.
Going to be dark blue. That's...
That is just, well, this is going to be dark blue there.
Ah.
And then...
Excuse me a minute.
That's the artwork for...
Hello? Your name Algernon?
No.
Oh, no, he's not here. Wrong number, sorry.
And then I thought, well, this would be the other colour.
This colour, yes.
Yes.
Do you want a cup of tea?
No.
Ethel's making a cup. She makes a lovely cup of tea. Would you,
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thanks very much. And you as well.
Nothing matters, nobody defends us.
or 12. Because it's just a little... I loved it.
Where?
It's a little loud. Oh. Later on, boys. I'm a bit busy now to have all this noise in the house. But it's lovely. Look. I love it. I'll have some later.
Not to worry about that. Look, I've written this terrific song, right? It's called How Can I Afford a Love? No, listen, you're like this. How can I afford a love? I can't afford a racket of Chris.
How does it go?
Leave it out, Harry. Leave it out.
You sing it, we'll have it.
Oh, it's a bit dark in here, Percy.
Well, I'm about to show a film, Ethel.
Oh, are you? What's that?
It's a postcard report.
Who's that from?
Smithy, remember?
Oh, he's lovely, Smithy. He does all these old songs, you see. I mean, I love all that modern stuff. I do love it.
Love
but
it.
But a touch of neuralgia once in a while.
She's right.
It's lovely.
Let's show.
Shall we do it?
All right.
Yeah. Oh, it's lovely.
Let's have a look.
Bit of an old song. It's lovely. He's terrific, Smith, isn't he?
He's great.
Very good chap. I love
great bloke.
Stuff.
Hello, Ethel. Hello, it's me, Smithy. You remember? We met at your street party in the summer. I know you said I should have kept in touch, but, I haven't really had any news till now. I've got a job. Choose a menu, sir. Any menu?
I love barbecues and carrots, please.
When I was a nipper, only 6 months old, my father and mother too, they didn't know what to wee me on. They were both in a dreadful stew. They thought of tripe, they thought of steak, or a little bit of old cod's roe. I says, pop round to the old cook shop, because I know what'll make me grow. Boiled beef and carrots, boiled beef and carrots. That's not you, yummy, kale. It makes you fat, it keeps you well. Don't live like vegetarians on the food we give to parrots. From morn till night, blow out your cock on boiled beef and carrots. We've got a lodger, he's an artful cove, I'm very, very queer, he said. We sent for the doctor, he came round and told her to jump in bed. The fella said, I do feel bad, my mother with a tear replied. What would you like for a pick-me-up? He jumped out of bed and cried, whoa! Boiled beef and carrots, boiled beef and carrots. That's the stuff you, Darby, care. It makes you fat, it keeps you well. Don't you like vegetarians, or the food will get the parrots. From all your life, no matter what. I am the brother of a lovely pair of kiddies and they're nice fat boys. They're twins, you can't tell which is which, like a pair of Savaloys. We had them christened in the week when the parson had them on his knee. Dad said, as they've got ginger hair, now wants their names to be. You've guessed it. Boiled beef and carrots, boiled beef and carrots. That's the stuff you Darby tell. It makes you fat, it keeps you well. Don't live like vegetarians on the food when you get to parrots. From morn till night, blow out your kite on boiled beef and carrots. La 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 la. Boiled beef and carrots, boiled beef and carrots. That's the stuff you Darby tell. It makes you fat, it keeps you well. Don't live like vegetarians on the food when you get to parrots.
Boiled beef and carrots! Boiled beef and carrots! I love that, wasn't it? It was just a shame
Ethel,
he burnt it.
Ethel,
it was a shame.
Please, please, Ethel.
What?
It was a shame, but
yeah.
Do you realise I'm trying to concentrate?
I like your hat.
Thank you.
What
you
like making
it?
Then?
Sandwich.
Oh, I hate making sandwiches.
I love
boring.
I love it, Ethel. Please, I am trying to concentrate.
I'm sorry.
Thank you very much.
Go on then, show us your worst.
There we are. Some nice Danish.
Another one?
Slice number two. Not too much. Bad for the old TikTok.
It's a very well-bred sandwich.
Mm-hmm. Oh, very clever.
Sorry.
All right. What shall we have now?
Ham.
Ham. All right, ham. Excuse me, Mr. Knight. Let it all hang out, so to speak. There we are. Nice bit of tomato. You say tomato, and I say tomato.
Yeah. I like tomato.
Love
Did
it.
You know that tomato is a fruit and not a vegetable?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mm.
Didn't know that at all.
It's not very interesting, I just thought I'd tell you.
Bit of egg. Some parsley. There we are.
Oh, that's good, Percy.
It's like a person with their tongue hanging out.
So it does.
Percival!
Yes,
Dawn!
Listen, I'm reading this terrific book here. It's called Oversea Under Stone. It's all about these three kids that go to Cornwall on their holiday to visit their great uncle Merry. Now, during the story, the three kids come across a really important document to do with King Arthur. Now, what they have to do is unravel a series of clues to get to this grail, which is buried. If I can get a bit of peace, I'll read a bit of it to you. You can certainly see them clear enough from the other side, Simon said, up, all interested. But there's such a long way across, Jane pointed out. I mean, the first clue might be that you have to take 10 paces to your left or something. It always is in stories about buried treasure. But to get to the standing stones up here, from over there, you'd have to take thousands of paces right across the arbour. Doesn't make sense. It doesn't have to be like that, Simon said. It could be something like compass bearings again. You know, perhaps we have to get something in line with something else to lead us on to a third thing. Barney closed his eyes and screwed up his face, trying to bring back a picture of the scene they had gazed at so hard the evening before. Do you remember when the sun set yesterday, he said slowly? The biggest standing stone was right bang in line with the sun from where we were. I remember because you could only see it if you didn't look straight at it, if you see what I mean. Simon looked closely at the manuscript again, excitement beginning to dawn in his face. Do you know, I think you've got something there, he said. This round thing drawn here over the standing stones that we thought was just decoration, perhaps it's supposed to be the sun. I mean, if he knew that the map wouldn't be found for years and years and years, he'd have to use signs like the sun. They wouldn't be likely to change. Come on then, let's go further up and have a look. Now, the clues and the story all unravel very, very fast, and it's all gripping stuff. But I can't tell you about the end yet, because that's the really exciting part, and I haven't read it yet. This is my favourite book at the moment, Oversea Under Stone. And this is going to go in the Loo Library Guide to Good Books, which I'll explain a bit about. Now, nothing's worse than getting a book which looks really terrific from the outside, and then you start reading a few pages and you think, this is boring, what a waste of money. So, the Loo Library Guide is set up just to put good books in. Now, if you've read a good book lately, or you're reading one at the moment, tell me the title, a little bit about the story, and why you particularly like it, and send it to number 73, P.O. Box 73, Southampton. If it's a good one, I'll put it in the loo. Well, no, I won't put it in the loo, but I will put it in the Good Loo Library Guide.
Yeah.
I say, okay?
Everybody in positions. Plenty of 69s.
Yes.
See you, Jimmy. Lift the list, Wessel.
Yeah. Is it? Yeah, so you're talking when I give you a nod to talk, right. And then when I cue you.
Don't.
Sorry.
This whole thing. The projector will be in the wrong place.
There we are.
It's all right.
Here we go. Hold the tiger.
Seven.
Surprise. I'm going to make a special drink called a lethal ethyl special. You're going to love it.
Beautiful.
This. I'll make one for Percy. It wasn't enough to go around,
beautiful.
Really. We have a cherry.
I gave my love a cherry.
Gave my love a cherry. Bit of sherbet.
Oh, lovely.
A bit of a lemon. And a lot of orange.
Vitamin C.
It's wonderful. I'll give it a stir.
Stir.
Try that. I'll get one for Harry, shall I? Harry!
Lovely.
Where is that boy? Where is Harold?
Love it. Don't know, I think. I think I saw him going to the loo.
Oh, he's always going to the loo, that boy. Well, I'll make him one anyway.
It's got me in it. You don't believe me? Take a look at this then. It had been a smooth flight for Harry and his co-pilot Dick, but high above the Pacific Ocean, something was wrong. I can't control her. We'll have to bail out. Dick? Dick?
Sorry, old chum. Any one parachute on board and I'm using it.
Harry battled to control the plane as it dived towards the sea below. An island. My one last chance. Got to pull over. Got to control her. As the flames died down, Harry began to hear voices. Sometime later.
I'm Lula. You're lucky to be alive. We pulled you out just in time. Now, sleep.
A few days later, Harry slowly recovered, but becomes puzzled about this strange island.
How did you learn English? Well, I'm an orphan, and the professor, my guardian, taught me. He was a scientist. He was sure there was a scientific reason why ships and planes kept disappearing in this area. He went out in a boat one day to investigate and never returned. Oh, but that's in the past, and I'm hungry.
Me too. I saw lots of fruit on the trees back there. I'll go and get some. By the time Harry came back, there was no fruit and no Lula. I wonder where Lula has gone. Looks like there's been a struggle. And this is Lula's bracelet. Wait a minute. What's this? She must have been taken to the Forbidden Mountain. The natives were too frightened to help Harry, so he would have to find a way across the Forbidden Mountain alone. I don't care what those natives say. Something strange is happening at this Forbidden Mountain. Lucky my portable hang glider wasn't damaged in the crash. Well, I haven't forgotten how to fly this thing. But wait, what's that coming on towards me? Oh no, it looks like zap, pow, boom. Missiles, whoops, down we go. I can't stay up for much longer. But little did he know what waited him below. Hours later, Harry came round. From what he could see, he was tangled up in the ship's rigging. And, on deck, looks tidy for an old wreck. Wonder what's under this hatch. Well, just look at that. Harry wasn't quite sure what he'd expect to find, but it wasn't mission control.
Well, Professor, you have one last chance. Tell me the secret, or do I throw the lovely Lola to the sharks? No way, Pop. You'll only cause more damage. Enough ships have sunk for you to loot. Not quite, Professor.
Harry instantly recognized the evil gangster, Papadopoulos. He's blackmailing the professor, and Lula's the ransom. Shortly.
Fire, sir! Systems 3, 7, and 8. Out of action!
The crew began to panic, as on deck. Harry fanned smoke into the control center.
Fire! Fire! We're done for! Let me out of here! Now calm down! That's an order!
Suddenly,
it's your secret agent.
Never mind who I am. Now let's have that pop gun of yours. Later, seems I came just in the nick of time.
Yes, you were the spark to the fuse. These poor men hated evil Papadopoulos. I don't know where you are, where you come from, or what you really do, but thank you.
Like a proper drinks factory in here. Here we go, 3 volunteers. The crazy cocktail makers. Some lime. What have we got, Lisa? Orange. Come on, got some nuts. Ginger ale. Come on, sherbet. Sherbet. Ew. Ew, what a nasty colour. Has everyone finished then?
I can't get that boy out of the... Oh.
Lovely selection here, Ethel.
What are you making? Lethal Ethel Specials.
Lethal
what are you?
Ethel Specials.
What's yours called? Got a name for it?
No. Bobby, no name?
No name. It's the No Name Special. What's yours called, Aaron?
Oh, very special again.
Oh, looks completely different. That's amazing, isn't it? Can I try one? Which one shall I try? Can I try yours, Lisa? Can I
What's in it? What's in it? Come on, tails.
I should say orange.
Orange.
On the colour. Mm-hmm. And. Pineapple. And ginger beer.
That right?
No ginger beer. Got that one wrong. Oh, that was lovely. You try one. Hey, you try. Try Bobby's. Go on, Lisa. Right. Up periscope.
It's nice.
It's nice, is it? You like that one? Can I try? It's the same straw. Right at the top of the straw. Oh, that tastes foul. No, kidding. Very good. Just have a quick taste of some one. But you know what they say about drinks, you know. The proof of the drink is putting it in you. Proof. Pudding. Tick. Sorry, Aaron. Sorry. Oh, Maltesers on the top. Yeah. That's novel.
Ethel.
Yes?
Let's watch a film while we're drinking them.
Oh, all that's right? A good idea. Let's clear a quick space and have the projector
out. Clear a space.
Excuse us. Ketchup. Who put ketchup
me,
in their drink?
Here it comes. Let's clear a space.
Clear a space. What is
there
the film?
Are. Stretch it right through.
Do you know what it is?
Poster film.
Oh. There lovely. I ought to make myself a drink, really, to have while I'm watching it, shouldn't
right,
I?
See what you know what they're doing.
Maltesers thing. Southampton 826011. Oh, no, I'm sorry, you've got the wrong number. No, that's all right. Phone was ringing anyway. Bye-bye. We just get nothing but wrong number calls. We don't get anybody who really wants to talk to us. Why is that?
I have made a poster.
Oh, you're so clever.
Of the phone number.
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
I'll put it under the address.
Yes.
There you are. Phone Southampton 826011.
Oh, that's very good. So you could phone us up if you wanted to, but we're very busy today. So if you couldn't do it today, please, but when I put the phone back on the hook, you know, maybe next Saturday or something, you could give us a call. Just take this and move it out of the way.
Excuse me, therefore, what are you doing with my letters?
Oh, if there's going to be a row, I'm going.
Excuse me. Spoiling my game, so she is. There we are. Sticks out now. Oh, never mind. Leave it here. Well, have you spotted all the letters yet? In the game, remember, there's 10 letters, makes up the word, right? And the clue is, adds up to 100, right? So keep your eyes peeled. If you know the word,
all right, come
send
on, time for making sandwiches. Come on, up.
This address.
Come back. Percival, hello?
Hello?
Hello? They do this to me every week, you see. I hate making sandwiches. I absolutely loathe it. And I've got to make sandwiches for all the band, and I just can't get anybody to help me. What I really need to do is to trick somebody into...
They're so amazing, right? They're so amazing. People's jaws just dropped open. It's
hello,
true.
Boys. We might play a game.
A game?
Yes, I thought we might play a game.
What sort of game?
Oh, you'll love this. You want to pop that over there, darling, out of the way? And we'll just put these few items for the game
here.
What's
all this about, then?
Now, what we're going to do is we're going to have a sandwich game. You're going to love this. You're going to love this. OK, you ready? Are you game? Okay, and
we're going.
Okay. Hands up, going for a sandwich, most exciting quiz game ever invented here at number 73. Musician. Right, now before we start, let's have a little word with the contestant, shall we? Tell me, young man, what's your name?
Tony.
Tony what?
Tony Hughes.
Tony Hughes, I don't know your father, Howard. Howard Hughes, very good. What do you do for a living there, Tony?
Play the trumpet.
You play the trumpet? That's very nice indeed. And what's your name?
My name is Steve Fix-It Fart.
Sound a little uncertain there. You're not quite sure, are you? Yes, now, what do you do for a living?
Nothing at all.
Oh, a politician. Fine. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into a few questions here. Every time you get a question right, you go for a sandwich.
Best
all right?
of luck, Tone.
Best of luck, Steve.
Oh, that's lovely. Odd but lovely. Okay. Now then, open question here. Who wrote the complete works of William Shakespeare? Tough one. Tough one. Come on, quickly now. I want to make a lot of sandwiches here. Billy Shakespeare, I'm afraid that's over to you. You shouldn't have helped him there. Piece of bread, going to go for a filling. What kind of a filling are you going to go for?
I'm going to go for peanut butter and ham.
Peanut butter and ham. Okay, now we're going to go a little bit of a question here. Before we start, I'm going to do a filling question. Can you place this stick? Have you got a stick? Will you have a knife instead? Can you place this knife behind your knees, bring your arms behind it, and place your hands on the floor in front of you?
No.
Absolutely right. Almost impossible thing to do. There you are. That's a filling for you. Now we're going to go back to another question here. How do you spell schizophrenia? Quickly now.
C-U-R-R-E-N-T-A-F-F-A.
Much closer than I would have been. That's a sandwich for you. Now we're going to go over to much more exciting sandwiches. We're going to have current sandwiches. I'm going to ask you a couple of current affairs questions. Just the one, perhaps. What date is New Year's Day?
Squidgy bun.
I'm sorry, no, that's absolutely incorrect. So that's a piece of bread away from you. Okay, so we're going to have a few questions here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. Instead of saying the word I want you to say squidgy bun. I'm afraid you leapt in there before.
Oh, sorry.
So it's your turn and you're going to go first. Right. Can you describe what you did this morning using the word squidgy bun instead of I? I hope you're playing this at home.
I wash my squidgy buns.
No, I'm sorry you said the word I. That's absolutely incorrect. So it's over to you.
Okay.
What do you call a large lump of frozen water that sits in the sea and bumps into ships?
Squidgy Bunberg.
Very good, absolutely correct, and you're our succulent sandwich award winner of the week. I've got a very attractive
thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much. Thank you. 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 Thank you.
That's a straight case.
And the Cuddies did an idea of films in Shepton on L Street, adjacent to it, not next door to it, is a recording studio where in fact they do all this thing as you know. So there's a 24-track machine here. So I walk off the set, through a door, and I'm back into my little world of music.
Well, oh, we're talking about the latest thing on the magazine scene, right? Only it's not a magazine, it's a tape. Now, you can get it at most newsagents around the country, and it only costs 50p, which is amazing, because normal C16 machines, tapes I should say, they cost a lot more. Julian, Jane, and mates, what do you think?
I think it's great, it's a brilliant idea. I think it's really good.
Yeah, I agree, it's a good idea, but the way they've presented it, the way they've executed the whole concept is, you know, not very good. I
think don't
just,
like that.
No, they've just got teething troubles at the moment. You know, soon, another couple of issues, it should get
better. It's got a couple of good things about it, though. What do you think?
Like, when you hear clips of music, I think that's really good, because on a magazine you wouldn't have that.
Yeah, right.
But I think they, I mean, when they're interviewing a group, they tend to talk across each other, and it just comes out as one big roar, and you don't know what they're saying or anything.
I think the worst thing about it, and I think most people agree with me, is the advertising on it. It's just, you know, it's very blatant, and it just interrupts the whole rhythm of the thing.
Do you like the idea of long interviews, or would you like them cut down?
No, they're much too long.
Too long?
Yeah, much too long.
Too long.
And I mean, the people they're with, you know.
What would you like to see most in the tape?
A bit more
tape?
About fashion, I think. A bit more fashion, because they didn't have hardly any fashion items at all.
More fashion?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I agree with that, and if they brought in a bit more information about clubs and things and where bands are playing.
But it is difficult. Obviously, this is number three, isn't it?
Yeah.
Number three tape. So I think they'll get better as they go along. I mean, like a few music magazines that I know of, when they first started out, they weren't so good.
And as I said, it's just teething troubles, but it should get better. Yeah. I hope it will anyway.
Will you buy the next one?
No, I won't.
You won't?
No, I'll borrow it off somebody.
You'll borrow it off
somebody? I'll borrow it off you, Harry.
Good idea.
Right, come on, Harold, stop chitting-chatting. Come on, take those sandwiches in. In you go, come on. Everybody in the lounge, come on. Everybody in the lounge.
We're about to do a song called Number 73, written by me. But unfortunately, I've been outvoted by the Q-Pips. So we might as well do their songs called Keep On Your Shoes or Keep On Your Feet or something like that. Anyway, cue Pips!
A one, two, three. Yeah!